slapstick theater. Apollos. This is Apollos.
Hello.
Who was a Jewish man and a great teacher of the early church after the days that Jesus was on earth. Apollos knew a lot about God, and he taught others about Jesus. He only knew part of the story of Jesus, though, so that was all he taught people. One day, he was in the Jewish synagogue in Ephesus.
Whoa!
And two people who knew Jesus' story well heard him preaching. Their names were Priscilla and Aquila.
Hey-o!
After Apollos was finished preaching,
hey, wait up!
Priscilla and Aquila pulled him aside and taught him more about God so he could understand even better.
Oh, all right.
Then Apollos went to teach at Achaia.
Whoa!
While he was there, he taught many people, and they believed in Jesus. He also met with the Jewish people there.
Well, hello, friend.
And using the scriptures, he showed them that Jesus was the Savior that they had been waiting for.
Thank you for coming to watch. Let's learn how to help our children to know the Apostle. When we talk about the Apostle, we often think that these people are the Apostle, who go to this...不同的语言、不同的文化的地方，然后带领人信主，一个再带一个。建立教会也是如此。可是宣教的一个很重要的一环，是训练那些可以来传福音、可以来讲道、可以牧养教会的。所以我们在圣经里面就看见也有这样的一位，在《使徒行传》第十八章第二十四节讲到，有一个犹太人，他来自埃及，他非常有学问，而且他能够讲解圣经，而且他心里火热。百居拉跟雅居拉这一对模范宣教士夫妻，他们就花时间来栽培这一位亚波罗，因为亚波罗他虽然对圣经很熟，可是他对主耶稣他的救恩还有一个空白。过了一段时间以后，亚波罗学习到了，然后他成为一个甚至比他老师更有能力传福音、建立教会的宣教士。圣经里面讲到保罗的时候，亚波罗他们两个是一起有同样的地位，我们就看见神给我们不同的恩赐。我们不应该妒忌别人，而且是怕别，或者是怕别人然后抢了我们的风头、我们的功劳。我们看见每一个人都有神所赐的恩赐。很明显的，保罗跟亚波罗他们有讲道的恩赐，但是其他的人有栽培、有关心、有其他的管理的恩赐。而且我们看见宣教不但是传福音，而且是要栽培更多的传道人。我们可以来告诉孩子，一个老师只能教几个学生，但是如果一个老师能够教好几个能够成为老师的学生们，那有更多的学生然后就能够得到知识。亲爱的家长，让我们一起来跟孩子来讨论什么是属灵的恩赐，跟天分有没有什么不同。我们来帮助孩子，然后对自己的属灵恩赐有个认识，所以他们能够继续的来操练。同样的，我们也来告诉孩子，帮助孩子来认识宣教士需要什么训练，他们的教育，他们需要的装备是什么。